Welcome back to a lecture series on GIS, and it is about today. The title of the discussion today is GIS Data Structure. We have seen GIS Data Structure 1 in the last lecture, and we will see in continuation to the GIS data structures and its advantages. We will see one by one that how this discussion is there. And the objective of this presentation, it is about the spatial data structure, how it operates, what is the topology, and what is the, you know, raster and vector formats are a way of defining spatial data in the computer. Topology is a special characteristics where it is used. We will see this is the objective to understand the different structures like raster and vector, and its relation in vector, how this is being, whether topology is employed in raster or not. No, normally it is. But vector, it applies, we'll see with these relations. And the presentation is outlined in this way, that vector data, raster data, raster vector of advantage and disadvantage. So this is the three major headings what we are going to see. In first one, the vector data, that is structure of raster vector data, raster versus vector. Coming to raster to vector, this is normally called as R to V or V to R. Applications where this is being mostly employed of this conversion from one end to another end. What is the advantage and disadvantages of the raster and vector, we will see. And when coming to the vector data, we have seen the raster format in the earlier discussion. How it works, it is very simple that all pixels are represented. But if you want to do it, here we examine how vector format works. Remember about the vector data, it is like a map. Raster, it is not like a map, it is know that it is pixels with values, but it is as like almost on par with the natural systems. And the vector data, as you know, that this is being represented in the form of point, line and polygon. This is a point entity, and a point is a single entity without any connections, you will see in the next line. This is a line representation, and this is a polygon representation. And a feature of a point, a point has no dimension, and is represented as a symbol that indicates its position. Where it is there, it is being indicated. This is the point, from here to here it is being represented. A line is a one dimensional feature that has length, direction, but no width. It is a one directional, it has a length, but no width, it is being represented. It is a one dimensional. Polygon, it is enclosed area, is called as polygon. The shaded features, you see, you have one, this is also polygon. Here it is also polygon, it is also polygon. It's an examples of water body, where you have water body and this place is empty, where you have complete water body. You can represent like this, you know, that it's enclosed area is called as a polygon. And this is being represented in a map, that you have rows and columns, as we know. And the vector data is represented by nodes and vertex. Nodes are the starting point and ending point is called as nodes, and in between it is called as vertex. A line, you take an example, this is a node, because you see that this is row, this is column. So it is almost 2 and 2. So nodes, one starts at the point exactly 2, 2. And it moves to the next vertex. In between, if you click by right click in the digital, that is called vertex. So it is of 8th column and 2nd row, and this is of 12th column and 7th row. And polygon is a closed, this one node. You have a node, and in between you have vertex, but it is a closed features. And wherever the node comes, you see you have third column and fifth row, and the 8th column and 5th row at next vertex. Connecting these nodes to vertex is called as chain. This is vertex 1. Connecting, this vertex to this vertex is another chain called vertex 2. And this node is the 10th column and 8th row. And this is again a chain, and it goes like this. So, this is the data structure of vector, how it is normally stored in the images. A point is one with a single entity without any dimension. So, it is represented at the 13th column and the first row. A line is one, it is actually shown in the last one. You see the point is blinked to understand. A line I have already explained. A line is one, it is a starting node and this is ending node. And in between, whatever the pressing, you know, that you want to connect the line is called as a vertex. Here we have given only one vertex connecting this nodes to vertex is called as chain. This is a first line and this is the first point and this is the second point and this is the third point. Similarly, you see that how the lines are digitized and it is moving from this place to this place and from this place to this place. And similarly, polygon is connected by nodes and vertex. Polygon starting, you start and then move digitized to the next vertex, next vertex, next vertex and next vertex to the last one and connect to the first one. This is called a polygon and in between I have explained in the last line. So, when you want to compare with raster versus vector, have different methods of storing the data because raster it is stored the data in the form of pixels whereas vector is stored the data in the form of points and lines polygons. So, this is the data storage type of your point is being represented in raster mode and vector mode. A line is represented in raster mode and vector mode and a complex line is represented by it is called a string format and this is called enclosed format. So, a single entity of a point in vector is represented as one pixel and a line it is represented by number of continuous pixels. Know that if it is a complex line, you know that you can go like this anywhere. And the polygon is a closed area in vector is represented by a closed raster structure. A point in a raster system is a single cell, but in a vector system, it is only symbol, single cell and symbol of precise coordinating position. A simple line in a raster system consists of sequence of cells which mistakenly gives the impression of width, you know that it is not exactly correct width of a road. This is the width of the road. In vector system, a line consists of two nodes minimum and a chain that connects in between them. A more complex line, sometimes called a string, this is called string in a raster includes cells representing a line that run in more than one direction. So, it is not only this direction, it is also running on the other direction. In vector system, in addition to the two nodes, you need to connect with the number of vertices. This is first node, second node, and in between are the vertices. Raster polygons fill the area with their borders with the cells. The vector format uses a single node. Single node, this is the starting node, and then you have in between vertices and connected at last. And what is R to B or V to R? It is simply a feature conversion. Normally, now all softwares will carry this R to B, V to R. Initially, it is required, you know, that when GIS was started, by the time now people are moving, it is inbuilt R to B or V to R. It is possible to change, convert from raster to inbuilt algorithms being done. The vector version looks more accurate. Remember, we changed accurate vector digitized file data to general raster. From raster only we are converting. And this is the conversion that you see that how your river looks and how you, when once if you digitized, this is a vector, but it looks like almost correct on the nature, on the surface. And application of raster to vector and that you once if you digitize you will be able to take printout in a plotter because it represents only lines, points and squares. It will be very easy. Visual form of features as like on the ground, it's you know that it's better for us to take every information as if the vector format gives more accuracy. And this conversion fit with all GIS, you know, that you can convert from one software to another software, it is more identical and facilitate data management. And topology is possible only in the vector format, not in the raster format. Topology is connectivity, adjacency, and there are three issues related to the topology we have discussed in the last one. It is well evaluated in the vector format, hence it gives more accuracy about the earth surface features. And coming to the advantage and disadvantage, that is the title of raster advantage, because it is a pixel, it is very simple data structure. If it is a pixel with a number, if you take 1 or 2, 1 or 2 to 100, you just superpose one over the other and then see the number, what is the, if you want to add or if you want to subtract or multiply, it will be more easier. So analysis easier, stacking is easier, no confusions here. Simple data structures has a lot of applications. And but the accuracy wise, accuracy because of we have seen in a line, that is the disadvantage, it is not moving, that is the disadvantage of raster data structure. Whereas coming to the vector, it looks like, you know, nature, as if it looks like, you know, this is the advantage, highest advantage. You can do lot of modeling analysis, you know, that you take coverage A, B, C, you superimpose and you ask your system to simply add, it will add to the new coverage and then give S3. So all mathematical modeling is very easy. And coming to all remote sensing data, it is being represented in the form of pixel value only. So whatever you do, all your analysis with respect to satellite data, it's being represented, scanned in the form of raster value. Raster applications are more because of this. And you see, you know, as I said, if you take two maps like slope and soil into 2.5, that is the erosion potential. So it's very simple. In no time, the raster will do everything. Disadvantage because of this one, you know, inaccuracy is more with respect to this, and what you see is what you get. This is what you call it as a principle in computer graphics, acronym is used, what you see is what you get. But in raster, what you see is not necessarily what you get, that is the policy, but vector, what you see is what you get. So because of this low resolution, sometimes, you know, what will happen, some of the pixels will carry a value called 0. Normally, it should not be a value called 0, so that it is meaningless to use for any sort of digital analysis. That is disadvantage. It is more like, you know, vector, coming to vector advantage, it is more like map. So, what you see is what you get is correct. And you see, you, this can be used for this policy of representing real world system. Higher resolution of vector format. Spatial accuracy is another plus, and we do topological linking or connectivity or adjacency assessment, and a compact storage, you know, that because, you know, volume is very less, but, you know, that is the disadvantage of raster data. It is in pixel form, volume is very big, volume is very not, because here you save only, you know, vertices, point, line and polygon. The high resolution support high spatial accuracy. Vector data you can do with the topology, that's what you are now connecting or checking. This is the speciality of this one. So it takes only very less amount of space in computer because it covers with only nodes and vertices. So public usually understand what happens on the surface of the earth because it looks like, you know, more unrealistic. But it is more difficult to manage because you have three different point is separate, line is separate and polygon is separate layer you are operating. More difficult to manage, long list of coordinates because of coding, you know, that you have point attribute table, point polygon attribute table, line attribute table. So whatever you do the operation, your attribute table in point, line and polygon will also get changed, and then it will also. So there vector formats occur, more powerful high tech machines, you know, that again system is very important. Because of this, we feel, you know, that you need a higher end computer system. People feel that raster is better because of simple structure, simple analytically, simple modeling. But vector is more accurate. You should not see, you cannot compensate the price for quality. Normally, people always works mostly with vector format. So, with this, the discussion about the GIS data structure 2 has come to an end. Thank you.